Hello there, I am Alan from Alan Woke, and welcome to this channel where I believe that in the theme song for SpongeBob SquarePants, it is in fact SpongeBob who does live in the bottom of the ocean under the sea. Just a theory. Speaking of theories... Where are you? Well, I can tell you where I'm not. I am not getting raided by the FBI like a certain someone we have all grown to fucking hate. I'm so sorry. That's right, this piece of shit right here. I'm just extremely happy right now. I feel very blessed in this moment that Jake Paul is going down. He's a bad, bad guy. Sorry, just flexing on the merch right now. I'm really hyped, I don't know why. I'm really excited to get into this video today. Basically like a top modern conspiracy breakdown. It focuses mainly on human trafficking, which is where I'm kind of at right now. And bringing light and awareness to the best way I know how through stupid jokes and stupid videos. I just want to bring awareness, and this is the only way I know how to. I know I make stupid videos and I make stupid comments and dumb jokes, but it's my way of doing it, okay? And if you don't like that, feel free to continue to watch my videos and support me anyways, because I do need support, emotional support. Anyways, let's get into the video. Number one, the silent children. So starting off with this one right here, let me talk about it first, and I'll tell you guys what I'm dealing with at the moment. So the silent children documentary, I'm sure you've heard me talk about it in previous videos, or if not, you've seen me post about it somewhere, or you've been seeing it be thrown around all over the internet. Basically, it's a documentary involving Vici, Anthony Bourdain, Chris Cornell, and Chester Bennington. All four have committed suicide, and all four allegedly have ties to this documentary, and all four have dealt with abuse in some way, or have been an advocate for sex trafficking or child abuse. So mostly it follows Avicii, who committed suicide days after releasing his music video for A Better Day. In the video, you can see multiple times that it's highlighting sex trafficking and abuse. In a statement about the music video, Avicii had this to say. Promise of a better life often traps families and children into being used as tools for some of the most despicable people on earth. It's an issue about which I hope to start a louder discussion, especially now with a huge number of families on the move from war-torn countries looking for safety and shelter. Which is sad because he did take his life, allegedly. It's possible. I'm not saying it's not possible. The problem I'm having right now is that I'm doing the docu-series The Unknown Known, where the first episode was based off of this documentary, The Silent Children. Sorry, my asshole neighbor has a fucking loud-ass motorcycle he likes to ride at the weirdest times of the day. So if you hear it, I'm very sorry. And then there's thunder. The fuck's going on in my life? But in the documentary, all four of these guys were allegedly connected, and I've come to find out that isn't the case. The only thing I really found that had any connection with these four people and the documentary was just Chris Cornell, who was the main financial backer for the documentary, and it was Linkin Park, who was set to appear in the film as music only, and maybe Chester Bennington was going to come in and talk about his story of child abuse. I just can't find it. I can't find evidence. I do apologize. I'm able to recognize when I'm wrong. I'm able to recognize when there's no longer facts. And that's an important part of being a human being. Don't forget that. It's okay to be wrong. More on Chester. Chester was set to appear in the documentary, allegedly speaking about his own story, in which he told Kerrang! Magazine in 2008. He revealed that an older man began to sexually molest him at the age of 7. According to Bennington, it was escalating from touchy, curious, what does this thing do, into a full-on crazy violation. I was getting beaten up and being forced to do things I didn't want to do, and it destroyed my self-confidence.
Number 2. Jenna Jameson.
We have Jenna Jameson going public about being raped and groomed for Hollywood pedophile elites. I mean, just look at these fucking tweets right here. Yeah, she's gone at it pretty hard. She's been the most vocal about these situations so far. And it's even come at Chrissy Teigen a few times, which brings me right to number 3. Good segue. Good job. Pat on the back.
Number 3, Chrissy Teigen.
Chrissy Teigen, number 3, makes several tweets relating to pizza And I'll get into that in a little bit as well. But for right now, let's just focus on Tegan. She deletes 60,000 tweets and blocks over 1 million followers on her Twitter. And if you don't believe me, she addresses it. "I actually deleted 60,000 tweets because I cannot fucking stand you idiots anymore. And I'm worried for my family. Finding me talking about toddlers and tiaras in 2013 and thinking you're some sort of fucking operative." Yeah, but like, you're talking about it, saying you feel like a pedophile for finding these half-naked children, as you said, attractive. That was fucked up. If you can't recognize that you were fucked up, and maybe you were just joking, I don't care. As we learned from Shane Dawson, you cannot joke about pedophilia on such a fucking... You cannot joke about pedophilia. It's wrong, and on some degree, I feel like it's not a joke to that person. Look at the rest of the tweets right here. It's fucking sick.
Number 4. Weird celebrity behavior.
Several celebrities with ties to Epstein and elite pedophiles go dark and do weird things. We have Ellen, who's getting canceled for a toxic work environment. She's posting these weird, crazy videos on her Instagram, which I talked about in my last video about Wayfair. We have Piers Morgan taking a break. Tom Hanks gets a Greek citizenship. Pedophilia is taken pretty lightly. It's addressed as a mental illness rather than an actual crime in Greek, which I think is just fucked on its own. Pedophilia is not a disease. It's a fucked up thing you do to another human being. Not a disease, not a sexuality. I don't give a fuck what they say. I get so heated about these things. Fuck, dude. What do you mean it's your sexuality to fuck a kid? No. No. It is not. Good. I'm good. I'm good. I'm good.
Number 5. Epstein didn't kill himself.
Epstein is murdered in jail for knowing too much. We all know about the Epstein theory, conspiracy, case, whatever you want to say. We all know about it at this point. Epstein didn't kill himself. It was even ruled as a homicide. As a medical examiner pointed out, that signs point to strangulation.
Number 6. Maxwell documents.
Maxwell. Judge orders release of private Epstein documents. Go watch my video on Maxwell to find out more about the topic. I won't dive too much into it because there's just a lot of shit, but that shit hits the fan, which I don't have in this room.
Number 7. Murder judge.
That same judge that ordered these documents be released. Her husband is shot. Her son is murdered. All in an attempt to assassinate her. I can't make this shit up. Also, fucking bold move, man. Bold fucking play to go after the judge that just ordered the release of documents. Like, how confident do you have to be in your fucking plan to just outright do that? Like, come on, it's so fucking obvious.
Number 8. Yummy.
Probably the weirdest one on this list is Justin Bieber makes a music video and a song called Yummy. And the video is allegedly pointing to Bieber himself being a victim of Pizzagate. I know. It's crazy. It's crazy. I get it. After the video was released, he made these super weird things. Like, on his Instagram, he would tag a bunch of baby pictures of random babies with the hashtag Yummy underneath it. And he also had the title of the song Yummy made out in a pizza graphic. And also, he pushed really hard for this really shitty song. I'm not gonna play it because I don't get the copyright claim again. Even though I did the Blink-182 thing earlier. The song just sucked, honestly. He tried really hard to get this song to number one. The Billboards, like, he released 3 different versions of the music video. He would ask fans to just, like, listen to the song even while they slept at night. Just have it on repeat constantly. There's a bunch of other weird shit with it. Feel free to look like yourself and come at me about it. At the start of his career, he did file a lawsuit against his former manager, L.A. Reid, for sexual assault. And this guy is also creepy as hell. He has plenty of allegations and plenty of restraining orders against him. And also, the video just has a lot of pedo term like symbolism in the video. If you don't know any of the terms that pedophiles use, then it's right here. I'll put a thing right here. That is the top modern conspiracy breakdown. If you want me to go further into one of those topics, please drop a comment down below and let me know. I would love to go further into it. I'm just giving a breakdown right now, so I'm sorry if I didn't give a fuck ton of information on it. Thank you guys for your continual support of the channel. I love every single one of you gorgeous people out there. Come in and watch my videos and like and comment and all the other crazy shit that YouTubers ask for. It means a lot to me, and I do deeply appreciate it. It's what keeps me going on this platform, honestly. And I've been getting discouraged some days, some weeks, some videos. I get really discouraged. Not to go on a whole rant about myself, but it is what it is, you know? Also, go check out the Are We Drunk Yet podcast. It's a really fun podcast that me and my future father-in-law do, where we pretty much drink beer and discuss whatever the hell we want to discuss. It's a good time. We have fun doing it. We would love to have more guests on. So if you're interested in being a guest on the podcast, please let me know. Drop some comments. Go to my Instagram and message us and me, either at Alan Woke or Are We Drunk Yet. I'll drop a link down below for both of those Instagrams. But also make sure you like and subscribe, because your like and subscriptions are the only thing that keeps Jake Paul off the internet. It's every day, bro. I know we all want that. Fuck nay, we do. Remember, guys, stay vigilant, stay aware of your surroundings, and most of all, stay woke. But I'll admit that I was glad it was